Okay, I am back. Whoop-dee-doo. I cut it off a little early yesterday because I was having issues with my mood. So I just figured, you know what? I'm gonna stop while I have the chance. Come back to it later, which is what I did. So, in advance, I apologize for not making the extra fourth video, but I was having so many issues and I was just done with everything at that point. Go back in real quick. Prepared myself a little better this time too, because I went and did some stuff. So my summons would already have their extra up and ready to go. Their overdrives, I mean. Because otherwise, we're just going to be here forever, is what I'm getting. So I just figured, have my summons have their special abilities set up immediately when summoned, so I can do a a decent amount of damage and keep this guy from healing too quickly. Because that would suck. Well, damn. He killed a freak. Fucking hell. And to be fair, my mood is still not great, but it's better than it was. So bear with me if I still seem a little off, but I'm better. I'm not perfect, but I'm better. I wasn't earlier. Earlier I was still kind of ticked. So I was having a little trouble being calm. I kind of lost my temper on two different people, but it wasn't even their fault. And I kind of just vented a little. And I feel awful about it. Yeah, that fight could have gone a lot smoother. To be completely fair.
Hey, come on, let's go. We are almost there, aren't we? We've come a long way. It's so funny.
You remind me of myself. Before, the closer I came to Xanarkand, the more I wondered. When we arrive, Braska will call the final Aeon. He will fight Sin, then die. I thought my mind was made up long before. But when I stood here, my resolve wavered.
Never would have figured. Legendary guardians choke sometimes too, huh?
Legendary guardian. I was just a boy. A boy about your age, actually. I wanted to change the world too. But I changed nothing. That is my story.
Oh. Poor guy. Dear Lord.
City dead for 1,000 years. A city I had to see with my own eyes. The end of Yuna's journey. The last chapter in my my story. My thoughts, they kept floating up and then slipping through my fingers, slipping away before I could pin them down with words.
You know, I say no. If we go down there, you...
You're a true friend, and I thank you, but I must go down to Zanarkand.
I'm not saying we shouldn't go, but should we think about it some more? There's gotta be some kind of way we can save you, Yuna!
All my life, I knew this moment would come.
I forget what he's doing.
Oh.
Never mind. I remember. Forget it. I remember now.
Sir Oren, Kimari told me, when my father wanted me taken from Lavelle to Hussein, it was you who told Kimari, right? I had always wanted to meet you someday. I am truly glad that I had that chance. Having you as a guardian was so great an honor. I don't know how to thank you. Perhaps if I defeat Sin, that will be my thanks to you. That's what I'll do. Yes. I will challenge Sin. I will defeat Sin. If you are all there watching this, then I guess Sin is already gone. And so am I. I suppose. Anyway, I just wanted to say, Sir Oren, I thank you. Kimari, do you remember the first day we met? I was only 7. My father had defeated Sin, and all of Bavel was celebrating. Everyone was saying what a hero my father was. I was so happy, but when night came, it occurred to me. My father had defeated Sin, and now he was dead. Now, I was all alone. I couldn't sleep. So I wandered into the town, away from the celebrating crowds. I stood on the bridge in Bavel, where my father and I had parted, standing there. Alone, I could see the fields where he had fought Sin. Then, you appeared, Kimari. You said you were looking for the daughter of Vraska, remember? At first, I was so scared. Until I realized what a gentle person you are. You weren't used to talking to children. When I told you that I was Vraska's daughter, you said you would take me as far from the fell as you could. That it was the wish of a man facing death. I think I cried then. Because that was when I knew my father was dead. And see him again. You just held me without saying a word. I cried after we got to Bisei, too. When you tried to go, after leaving me the care of the temple, I held on to you crying, "Don't go, don't go." And you listened, Kimari. You stayed. Kimari, thank you. Thank you so much. And I've always liked your broken horn. Waka, Lulu. I'll never forget my days spent with you. Growing up in Bisei, we always played together, us and Chapu. That's why I was always so happy, I think. And when you refused to let me become a summoner, and I did it anyway, I'm sorry. I've always wanted to apologize. You know, when you tried to stop me then, really, I was happy. I could tell you really cared about me. You were like my big brother and sister. No, I think you really were my big brother and sister. What else? I love watching you play blitzball, Waka. I even love it when you scold me, Lulu. Really. I guess that leaves the newest guardian. Star player of the Zanarkand Aves. You are. Never being together again at all. I'm afraid. No, I shouldn't say that. I'll do that part over.
What you up to?
There's just a crack in the wall. Okay. Well, anyway, my heartstrings have been tugged at again. Yay! That was a long thing, wasn't it? Such a long walkway.